Hi everybody, it's Hannah here with another video, and I'm gonna be reading some medium to small, very short scary stories. And I hope you guys like these kind of videos. If you do, please like and subscribe and invite more people to our new fam. So yeah, so here it goes. This is one of the first ones that I'm going to read to you guys off of a computer right here, and it's going to be called Seeing Red, the First Day of School. So here it goes. Everyone loves the first day of school, right? New year, new classes, new friends. It's a day full of new potential and hope before all the dreary depression of reality of showing up to ruin all the fun. I like the first day of school for the different reasons, though. You see, I have a sort of power. When I look at people, I can see a sort aura, around them. A color line based on how long the person has lived. Most everyone I meet around my age is surrounded by a solid green hue, which means they really have plenty of lifetime left. A far amount of them have a yellow-orangish ting around them. Each teamed they tend to mean a car crash or some other tragedy. Anything that takes them before their time, as they say. The real fun is that when the Arias ventures into the red end of the area, though. Very now and then, again, I'll see someone who basically is a walking spotlight, or have those who are the ones who get murdered or kill themselves, such as a rush to them, and know their time is numbered. With that in mind, I always get into class very early so I can look out my classmates' fates. The first kid who walked in was basically very red. I chuckle to myself, too damn bad, bro. But as people kept walking in, they all had the same intense glow. I very caught a glimpse of my rose tint reflection in the window, but I was too stunned to move. Our professor stepped in and looked the door. His color is sickening shade of green. And then that's the first one. And then the second one I'm going to be reading to you guys is My Daughter Learned to Count. My daughter woke up around 11:50 last night. My wife and I picked her up from her friend Sally's birthday party, brought her home, and put her to bed. My wife went into the bedroom to read a while. I fell asleep watching the Braves game. Daddy, she whispered, tugging my shirt sleeve. Guess how old I'm going to be next month. I don't know, beauty, I said as I slipped on my glasses. How old? She smiled and held up her four fingers. It is 7:30 now. My wife and I have been up for almost 8 hours, and she refuses to tell us where she got them. Ooh. I'm gonna read one more, and the next one is gonna be called Hell. There was no purely gate. The only reason I knew I was in a cave was because I had just passed the entrance. The rock wall rose behind me with no ceiling in sight. I knew this was the religion I talked about, what man feared. I had just entered the gate to hell. I felt the presence of the cave as if it was a living, breathing creature. The stench of rotten flesh overwhelmed me. Then there was the voice. It came from inside and all around. "Welcome. Who are you?" I asked, trying to keep my calm. "You know," the thing answered. "I did know. You are the devil," I shuddered quickly, losing my temper. "Why me? I live as good as I could." The silence took over the space as my words died out. It seems like an hour went by, therefore, wait,